I'm Steve Jobs. It is 1950. IBM passes up the chance to buy a young fledgling company that has invented a new technology called Xerography. 2 years later, Xerox is born, and IBM has been kicking themselves ever since. It is now 10 years later, the late 70s. In 1977, Apple, a young fledgling company on the West Coast, invents the Apple II, the first personal computer as we know it today.
Something that's not just a little bit different. It takes something that's really new and really captures people's imagination. And the Macintosh, of all the machines I've ever seen, is the only one that meets that standard.
God, look at that. Look, I'm on television.
Hey.
The early 80s. 81. Apple II has become the world's most popular computer, and Apple has grown to a $300 million company, becoming the fastest growing corporation in American business history.
The people at Apple decided the only way to succeed was with a radically different computer.
The Macintosh is small and friendly, almost cute for a computer, and people who see it get excited.
I mean, I sat down and operated this computer, and I didn't know anything about it. All I did was point the thing to the little picture, and it did it.
My instantaneous reaction was to say that this was the greatest thing that had been invented since.
This thing eats 8088s for breakfast.
Remarkable people, none of which are sitting up here, you know, today.
Well, not us.
Oh, you're sort of it.
Proud of showing for the crown of creation. So, that didn't look so good, but then somebody at Scientific American had the insight to test the efficiency of locomotion for a man on a bicycle. And a man on a bicycle, or a human on a bicycle, blew the Condor away, completely off the top of the charts. And that's what a computer is to me. What a computer is to me is, it's the most remarkable tool that we've ever come up with. And it's the equivalent of a bicycle for our minds.
It literally changed the way we live our lives every day. Steve Jobs, the visionary founder and leader of Apple Computer, has died at the age of 56.
The 56-year-old founding father of Apple Computer and Pixar Studios died tonight. He is mourned by his wife, four children, and millions around the world who could not wait to see what he would come up with next.
As it should be, because death is very likely the single best invention of life. It's life's change agent. It clears out the old to make way for the new.
For being a strong leader and being brash, but to me, he was just always so kind, such a good friend, and I'm just going to miss him.
Steve Wozniak, co-founder of Apple. Thank you very much. That's it. Thank you. Yeah, I really appreciate you talking to us.